In this lecture, we discuss about Shokley, Reed, and whole recombination. This is an indirect recombination. And I have already discussed about direct recombination, indirect recombination, and traps. So this Shokley-Reed and whole recombination is an indirect recombination process. In this recombination, electrons from the conduction band minimum come to a defect level. Intermediate between EC and EV by radiating energy as photons or phonons. And from there, they go to valence band. Therefore, the presence of defects is essential for this recombination process. Meaning is that in this recombination process, electrons first go to an intermediate level. Let's understand it by this Venn diagram. This is maximum of valence band and this is minimum of conduction band. So in Shokley, Reed and whole recombination process, electron from the minimum of the conduction band first goes to this intermediate level, which is created by a defect, and from here so this electron goes to this defect level by releasing an energy in the form of photon or phonon. So in next step, this electron from this defect level will go to this valence band. Again, by releasing its energy, which is equal to this difference. Again, this difference may be in the form of photon or phonon. So here we can see that a defect is necessary to complete this recombination process. The mechanism of this recombination process has been investigated by Shockley Reed and Hall. Therefore, this indirect recombination process is known as Shockley-Reed-Hall recombination. And this recombination process is occurred with deep level centers. It is worth to note that many recombination centers have more than 1 energy level. But in most of the case, only 1 level dominates the recombination . Therefore, here we will keep our discussion confined to single level, recombination. The four steps that occur in recombination of an electron hole pair through a deep level center are. So there are four steps that involve in this Shockley read and whole recombination, and these steps are, let me first draw this Venn diagram. This is 2, 3, 4. So this is before and this is after recombination. So if, and once again, this is EC, that is minimum of the conduction band, and this is EV, maximum of the valence band. Similar is here. And let me draw deep level here. So this deep level has energy ET. Similarly here, so in first step, electron from the conduction band can be trapped here. So after trapping by deep level impurity, electron will go here. Similarly, an electron from deep level can go to conduction band, and therefore there is a hole from where this electron is coming. Second thing is, electron from this impurity level can find an hole in the valence band, and after this a hole is created here, and here in valence band electron hole pair is annihilated. In another case, an electron electron from the valence band can find this hole in the deep level, and after going from valence band to this ET level, there is an electron here, and corresponding to this electron, there will be a hole in the valence band. So this step I am marking as A, this one is B, this one is C, and this one is D. So now what is this A? Here in step first, electron is captured, or this step we can electron capture. In second step, there is an electron emission. So this step is known as electron emission. In third step, a hole is captured by this impurity level. And in fourth step, a hole is emitted, or we can say it as hole emission step. So now I am going to write all these steps in detail so that you can understand better. And here, as we know, the arrows in this diagram indicate the transition of the electron in the process. So process A depicts the capture of an electron from the conduction band by the center or impurity center or defect center or deep level center, whatever you want to say it, located at energy ET. And the emission or we can write it in another way, that is the inverse of the emission of the electron from the center into the conduction band, is shown in process B. Meaning is that emission of the electron from the center into the conduction band is shown in process B. And process C or step C, whatever you want to say it, process C represents the capture of a hole from the valence band by the center. Here, center emits the captured electron into the valence band. Which is equivalent to the transfer of a hole from the valence band to the center. Finally, process D, the center capture an electron from the valence band leaving behind a hole in the valence band. This is equivalent to centers emission of a hole into the valence band. From these four steps, it is clear that if the level is to act as an efficient recombination center, the electron capture process A must be followed by the whole capture process, that is process C, and both of these processes should have nearly the same probability. So, from these steps, we can see that if this impurity level is acting as an efficient recombination center, then this step, that is step 1, is must be followed by step C. So that an electron can be go to this valence band through this impurity level, and the probability of happening of both of these steps must be the same. And if process A is followed by the electron emission process, that is process B, then the center acts as an electron trap, and I have already discussed about the difference between recombination center and trapping center. And similarly, when process C is immediately followed by process D, then the center acts as a hole trap. So from here we can see, if we go to again on this diagram, if process A is immediately followed by this process B, then this is a trap but not the recombination. Similarly, if step C is immediately followed by step D, then this is a whole trap, not the recombination. For acting this impurity level as an recombination center, step A must be followed by step C, so that this impurity level can act as a recombination center. So now we have to determine the energy required, or where it should be this impurity level, so that these impurity levels can act as a recombination center or as a trapping center. And this we will do in the next lecture.